All right, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, Ecom Tom here. My name is Tom Cormier. I sell well over six figures a month on eBay with eBay dropshipping. I have an eBay Facebook group, mainly eBay Facebook group, coaching course, mentor, everything. If you guys haven't seen my videos, that's a little lowdown about me. And in this video today, I do want to go over a little bit about my current sales. And it is September 12th. So what are on a lot of people's mind today is about the fourth quarter, the upcoming fourth quarter. When does it start? What's happening? What am I doing to, you know, get myself in a proper position for just the fourth quarter in general? So all that's going to be covered in this video. And without further ado, let's get into it. So for a little bit of motivation, this is just basically my sales for the last 30 days on PayPal. So I have three accounts. So I put them all together on the one PayPal thing. And as you can tell, I've done a lot of sales in the last 30 months, 188, almost 189,000 in sales. And today has just started. It's 12:39 PM. So I can only imagine that I'm going to hit 190 something, maybe 194-ish region today. And we're going to go from there. So let me ask you guys a question. You can comment below. You guys can leave, you know, comment, like, whatever. Do you guys think you're at where you should be with your eBay dropshipping business? Have you guys been doing this and getting good results? Have you been doing this for too long and getting no results? I want to hear from my audience because I want to know where basically everybody is in this business and just what you guys really need or want out of me, because I have infinite amount of videos I can make, but I'm looking for feedback from people, from my subscribers, from my viewers, of what you guys want to see videos on and what you guys need help with the most. Because the one thing I can say is that with the upcoming fourth quarter coming in, you want to be in your best effort. You want to have everything in line for the fourth quarter in order to make the most sales possible and really capitalize on literally the highest spending time of the year. So with that being said, what am I going to do for the fourth quarter, you guys may be asking? I've gone over a little bit. I did a YouTube live with Mark from DS Genie, or No BS Dropshipping on YouTube the other day, and we did go over it a little bit. I'll tag it in the cards above so it'll come across the top. You guys can just click that. But what am I going to do? So I have a few things that I am planning to do, but the number one thing that I can suggest that you guys can do is if you are on the fence about eBay dropshipping in general, you haven't made any movements, or you've just been dabbling in it and not really doing anything, it's go all in. You need to fucking go all in the fourth quarter, because that's when you're going to make a lot of money and that's when you're going to see the results. So the one thing I wrote down already is stop procrastinating. If you haven't started yet, start now. You have two more weeks until whatever, the fourth quarter. I started literally a year ago around this date. I listed my first product on October 15th, 2017. And by the end of December, I was hitting around 20,000 in sales for the last 30 days. So it can be done. I'm telling you, it will drop off after December, but that's going to give you the footing. And like, the way to learn is to be by making sales, by doing returns, by doing everything that you need to learn the ins and outs of the business. And the ins and outs of the business come a lot faster during the fourth quarter, not the slow periods in like January where it might just be slow in general. You don't really learn it. You don't really like it. You know, it's not fast enough for you. You're not making enough money, so you quit or something like that. In like November, December, it's going to be going too fast for you. I'm telling you that right now. Or it's going to be just going just fast enough. So you're going to want to really just go out there and just give it your all and really just try your hardest to just make this the best fourth quarter you can. And I'm going to stop sharing my screen because I went off on a rant and I still have my screen shared. So now you guys are going to see me in my glory right here. So that's for the beginners. These are the people that haven't started yet. But what if you've already started? What if you've already been selling, you know, a decent amount and you want to really ramp it up for the fourth quarter? What are my suggestions? So I wrote down three right here. And I'm going to look. And one I would say is fix like that manual process that you always do. That's kind of a pain in your ass, but you do it every day. But you just do it anyways because it's easy to do. It doesn't take up like too much time, but it still takes up time every day. So something like that could be ordering by hand. Like if you're ordering things by hand, copy and pasting, if you're really a beginner, then move up to a tool like SmartyDrop. I talk about SmartyDrop in my course. And SmartyDrop's basically a tool that copies and pastes everything at once instead of having to go one line at a time. If SmartyDrop's getting to be a burden for you or too much, then switch over to auto-ordering. SaleFreaks has a great auto-ordering system, and there's a lot of other auto-ordering programs out there. So you can use something like that for auto-ordering and really just expedite your process. So it's things like that. If you're doing like some very, very, very manual sourcing, why don't you get Zik Analytics so you can source faster or something like that. just like always try to ramp up the process that you're doing and always try to make it better and just more fast than what it already was. So that's like the number one thing I could say that'll save you great amounts of time, because you will be making more sales in the fourth quarter. So you don't want to be wasting your time on other things like just sourcing or doing things manually and stuff like that. So on top of this, I preach it all the time, and I'm going to come out with a course on it eventually because so many people have been asking me about it. We've already started researching and brainstorming on what we want to do, me and my business partner, and that is just hire a VA. If you don't have any VAs, then hire a VA. If you have multiple VAs, maybe hire another VA. I mean, there's going to be all sorts of extra things going on, more returns, more orders, more everything, customer service. So you want to really just make sure that you have enough hands on board. If you're not doing this full time, if you have a job and other things on the side like that, then you are going to want to make sure that you have enough things covered or enough just people with their hands in the business covering your ass on every single situation. So I have 5 virtual assistants right now, and I am looking into getting a 6th virtual assistant just for this season. But we're going to see how it's going so far, because sales have been pretty consistent at around 200,000 a month, or close to 200,000 a month. So, I mean, I can only imagine what I'm going to hit in the fourth quarter in the next 3 months. And I can't be more excited for it, because it's going to be a lot of money coming in. So the last thing I really want to talk about, I wanted to make this video short in general, is just time management. You really don't want to be wasting your time. And I'm a big Gary Vaynerchuk fan. Some people find him annoying, and I also do kind of find him annoying. But he always talks about time management. You have 18 hours in a day where you're awake, usually maybe 16, whatever, depends on how much you sleep. But you need to utilize all those hours of the day. You cannot be wasting time on your cell phone, wasting time watching Netflix. Netflix, I'm a big advocate of Netflix, is the biggest downfall of society. Everybody sits there and just watches hours and hours of Netflix every day and just gets nothing done. Like, stop procrastinating, stop wasting your time, and just go out there and work. Like, if you work the amount that I work, or the amount that like Mark from DS Genie works, or other people work, you will see huge leaps and bounds in your progress. You, like, even if you were sourcing manually that many hours that like I put in a day, or like even after your job, you work 9 to 5, what are you doing between 5 and midnight? And that's really what's going to help you and help your business grow. That's what I did. I didn't quit my job until after fourth quarter of last year. So I worked October, November, December full time at an engineering firm. And then when I came home, I was working at it during work too, on lunch break and like when I had downtime, but also working on it right when I got home until literally when I went to bed, learning new things, learning how to do this new program, this new thing here, doing this, ordering, listing more, you know, things like getting another virtual assistant. You really need to make sure that you are using your time wisely, and don't worry about what's going to happen or if you're ready for it or not. I'm a big advocate of, you know, learning about 30 to 40% of what you need, and then just jumping in and, you know, flailing for a bit, figuring everything out. But you'll be happy that you did, because you'll get a lot more done. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You guys did say in the last video that I made, and, you know, more motivation type things, that I should, you know, start putting more motivation posts out there and videos out there. I do think that this video did touch upon that. We are going to have a decent deal coming out for the fourth quarter for the course. So you've been on the fence. Like I said, you want to get started, stop procrastinating. You want to cut your learning curve in literally like 1/10 of the time. If you get my course, I can guarantee you that it will cut your learning curve down, and that you'll be making sales by the, like, blowing up in sales by the time that fourth quarter comes around or ends. So we've got about 70 students in the course now, and it seems like everybody's loving it. I've had multiple people reach out to me just today, telling me that they want to do testimonials for the course. One guy had a problem with his credit card because he made too many sales. He made like 75 sales yesterday, and his credit card was like, you know, registering as fraudulent or something. So, I mean, things like this happen. They're not the worst problems ever, as long as you know how to figure it out and keep your head down, keep grinding, and keep working towards it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video about the fourth quarter. And if you don't want to join the course, if you don't want anything like that, the least you could do for yourself is just join the free Facebook group below. Because if you join the free Facebook group, you'll see a lot of the content that I post out there. You'll see a lot of the questions that people are asking, people are answering. There's a lot of great content in there. I post all my YouTube videos in there and other content that doesn't always go on YouTube, because YouTube isn't really the place for it. So the link's going to be below for that. And if you want to see, there's a bunch of other links below. So check all of them out. See what you like. A lot of it's free. So just go for that. Give it hell. And just really, if you're on the fence, just fully commit to it. And when you fully commit, that's when everything is going to come into place. I can tell you that right now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. See ya.